Is Microsoft Edge on Android mobile any good? Let's put it to the test. Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. My name's Tony, and this week we're gonna look at Microsoft Edge on Android mobile. Now, a couple of weeks ago, I did a video on Edge on an Android tablet, and my verdict was it was okay. It wasn't as good as the desktop version, but it still did the job and I still use it. In that video, there were a few comments saying that the mobile version is even worse and not to try it. Well, I can't complete a review of Microsoft Edge without trying it on a mobile device, so that's what I've been doing for the last week. Now, everybody's experience will differ when using Microsoft Edge on mobile, depending on which device you're using. For this, we're going to use my own Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus 5G, which carries the Exynos 9825 chipset, and it has 12GB of RAM. And as I said on the last video, this is an Android device, so we're going to have to download it from the Play Store. We're not going to go through the download. If you really want to see that, it's covered in the Edge on Android tablet video. But suffice to say, all you need to do is download it from the Play Store. You'll be asked to sign in. This is where auto-sync is turned on, and the things you can sync are your favorites, your autofill, and your passwords. It will then ask you a bunch of questions about usage data, and then you will get to the home screen. So now it's downloaded, let's have a look at the user interface and see if it's any different from the tablet version. Okay, so once it's downloaded and you're logged in, you will get taken straight to the home page. Now, you can see the difference between this and the tablet version, as all the menu is on the bottom instead of being on the top. The only menu button you've got at the top is the hamburger buttons, and that is to customize your new tab page from focused, inspirational, or informational. And you can have a custom one for the image of the day and all that stuff. So that's from there. Obviously, you've seen your quick links tab, and then depending on what you've got your new stories. That's all pretty basic as it was. Everything else is on the bottom, which I think is the best idea, as this can be used now one-handed. If they were at the top, you couldn't really get to them. So let's go through the buttons. Self-explanatory, the first two are back and forward. We'll get to the middle one in a minute because that opens up the rest of the icons. Number there is how many tabs you've got. That's two tabs currently open, and the share button. So if you click on the three dots, it will, first of all, it will open this, and the first five on there: favorites, history, collections, which we'll talk about in a bit, downloads, and settings. Now, in the settings, they're pretty much the same as what was on the tablet. Appearance is one of the first things I do. It's pretty much the only thing you can do in the settings, apart from change the language anyway. So once that's done, we've now got that on the dark mode. And the next thing I do, I don't know if I've already done it, is change search from Bing to Google, which has already been done. Or DuckDuckGo, that's up to you. But everything else is in there is standard for both Android versions. Your ad block, your privacy and security, your tracking, all that's in there. You can turn that on and off. So that's your settings. Now, inside here, if you come up once more, you'll see all these other icons. Now, the ones that are blacked out are currently not in use because you don't have a web page open. But what you can do is you can customize it, because the first time you press it, like I said, you'll get the first five there, which will remain the same. It'll also show you the first five on top. Now, if these aren't to your liking, you can click on change menu, and let's go to continue on PC. You can move that and swap it with one of the five. So you'll get your five most used, the top there, and the default five from there. All the ones on there are pretty self-explanatory. Continue to PC, web search, home. I don't think there's nothing in there that's new, but you get the idea. It's all one-handed operation, all from the bottom. That's really user-friendly. Let's have a look at a website.
Once you've opened up your web page, you will see now that all the icons are now grey, so you can use them. There you go, that's the user interface.
So there's a quick look at the user interface and some of the menu buttons. I think Microsoft have really thought about this. If you go into Google Chrome, all the menu items are at the top of the screen. Now, the Note 10 is a big phone, but phones are getting bigger and people do use these with one hand. I cannot use Chrome with one hand on this phone as everything's at the top. So putting the menu at the bottom, which can be just used with your thumb, makes it a hell of a lot more easy to use than Chrome. Again, something else that they have thought about with Microsoft with the mobile version of Edge is collections. That's no secret, I use collections all the time, and it's one of the favorite features that a lot of people do use within Edge. Now, the mobile version does sync across all your devices, but you can collapse the menu to the bottom so you can still browse, and you can collapse even further along the bottom, which makes it a lot more easier, again, for one-handed operation. Let's have a look at that now.
So collections then, this works miles better than on the tablet version. If you open up your collections, open up one of your collections then, I don't know, open up a page, or while you're surfing, you're looking at your page, you can open up selections. Now, you can see the collections is open at the bottom. There's three views you can have. You can either open fully, which means you can't see the website you're looking at. You can have it along the bottom, as it is now, which means you can still carry on with your browsing. Or you can take it down a little bit further, so it's minimized right at the bottom, and lets you carry on. And you can just manipulate it how you want, all done with one hand. I think it's brilliant.
So that's collections then, and I think it works really well on the mobile. So now I just want to look at download. This is one of the things where I've seen in various places in reviews where it's brought the score down. People are complaining that you don't know where it's downloading to and you can't find your downloads. Let's have a closer look at it now.
So just a quick look at downloads then. I'm on the Canon website for the EOS M50, which is the camera I'm using, and we're just going to download a manual. Now, I've already used download before, but when I was setting this up, on the very first time I downloaded, it gave me two options where to save my downloads, either in the downloads folder on the phone or on the SD card. Them are the only two options. So I presume them are the only two options where they can save. But to find them, it's dead easy. So let's go for, there we are, M50 user manual. Download, accept and download. It's downloading. And it's now downloaded. So that's the manual downloaded. Now, as before, if you go into the menu on the top five of the row, you'll see the fourth one there that says downloads. And there it is. That's how you access your downloads. Simple and easy. Now, when I set Edge up, I chose a download folder as the default. In there, recent files, downloads, there it is. Not hard to find at all.
Now, I'm not going to cover much else. It's just covering old ground that we touched on the Android tablet and the desktop within Edge itself. And to be honest, I think the mobile version of Edge works better on the mobile than it does on the tablet. Yes, there are still some bugs in there. When I go into the bottom menu, some of the buttons do not work. They're blacked out. Now, at first, this was because I didn't have a web page open. So they only become active once you've got a web page there. But some of the buttons just will not work, just stop working. And a simple restart of the app fixes the issue. So it's not anything to do with having a web page open or not. Something that needs to be sorted. It's a mild hindrance, but the bugs are still there. All in all, I do think this version is better than the Android version. I've not experienced what other people have been commenting on about it being slow and really buggy. Now, the version I've got here, I think it's 45, which was updated on the 5th of September. So I don't know on that update if they've improved on what people have commented on beforehand. But for me, I'm quite surprised. I expected this to be quite poor from what I've read. And it's not. It's definitely better for me than the tablet version, and it's better, again, in my opinion, than the Google Chrome browser. Guys, there you go. I hope you got something from that. I fully expect some comments disagreeing with what I said. Please do put your comments in the bottom. Tell me what you disagree with. Tell me why it's bad and we can have a discussion. If you like that, please give me a like. It really does help. If you haven't subscribed yet, that's up here. And if you want to see some more videos, I'll stick some here. Until next week, guys, see you later.